for his first solo performance. He's coming to Baltimore from Providence to perform at the NX Theater for this wonderful event. So, without any further ado, I would like to ask you to turn off your cell phones, quit smoking, and pay close attention to Peter Glantz's Being Impossible. Whee!
Lit a match and touched into your skin. And I said, I'd probably say, ouch. And then he said to me, what you need to do is learn a different reaction than ouch. So that's what I'm trying to do here. And I've been thinking about it, and I don't want to just spend all our time and resources and all that stuff building some giant mega machine in order to go to the sun. I want to do it another way, something more efficient. And so these experiments are the beginning of that process. So this experiment that we're about to do is actually an advancement on the initial line projector adapter experiment. When we all put our hands in the air and stick our tongues out, at that moment, our collective consciousness will become a single image, a moving image that will go to the projector and go onto the screen. And we will simultaneously witness what it is that we are all about. If it works. So, let's go for it. Remember, I'm not going to explain, just follow along. Ready?
Your heart is a prison.
Change is easy.
It's time for togetherness.
been traveling around in different times, as different animals, different planets. And I'm finally human again. And so, since I've been human, I've been trying to prove to people that what I'm saying is real. But nobody believes me. They say it's fake. So what I'm here now to do is to show you that it's real. See, what I've been doing in order to prove the truth of this many lifetime existence is to separate my spirit from my body. And I haven't just been doing that as a means of proof. I've been doing it to complete the assignment I was given originally to get to the sun. And when I was doing that, I learned a few things that I need to tell you about. But I think that you will only be able to understand them if I first prove that what I'm saying is real. And I'm going to do that by manifesting my spirit separate from my body as a orb of white light that surrounds me.
Yeah.
Woo! Well, I'm feeling good. I should strike while the iron's hot. I feel like I've got support from the audience.
Ha 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 ha!
all of our minds simultaneously. And I'm going to use this box, which I've been scared to use ever since its first use. But it's so powerful, I require it for this experiment. I'm going to open it up, look inside, and use that as the inspiration for this psychic television episode.
Exercising myself.
Oh. Well, I was exercising my ability to see beauty in the world.
How do you do that?
So you're gonna close your eyes, and then you open them, and when you look around, you notice how beautiful the world is. Wow. What a beautiful world. Get it?
I'm having trouble with this.
Okay, I have these objects on the table and you can look at them for practice. Just focus on one object. Okay, ready? So you close your eyes and you open them. Wow, what a beautiful world it is. Do you see it?
I don't know, this is pretty hard.
Yeah, it's kind of hard. Well, let's try it again. Close your eyes and open them. Wow.
I feel like I'm getting better at it.
Yeah. One more time.
Should I close them for a long time?
No, just a second. Or short if you.
I think I'm starting to get it.
You got it?
Yeah.
I'm having trouble with this.
Did you look at the onion? Okay, ready? Close your eyes. Open them.
Oh, wow. I think I did it a little bit.
Wow.
Yeah, I think it is a beautiful onion.
And now, let's do one where we close our eyes and open them and then we look at each other.
Oh, okay.
Okay, ready? Close your eyes and open them.
Miranda, you are beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
You too, Becky.
You too, Jim. You too, Miranda.
Thanks, you guys are beautiful too.
Right on.
This is hard work. Lots of exercise.
Yeah, this is exhausting.
Yeah, maybe it's time to go do some singing and dancing.
Yeah.
She was a bear. She sang about changing your relationship to nature. And then you may remember her as a raccoon, talking about how easy it is to change. And as a harp in space, and also as a bird, talking about prisms and togetherness. She's been through it all. And Most recently, she was a part of this psychic television program, and now I'm going to, because we have advanced together to this point, I'm going to attempt to communicate with her directly into her mind, and her into my mind. We're going to share a single mind space and have a conversation together right now. And we will use the mind projector adapter so that you can witness this experience. And I have to tell you what's most dangerous about this, because many of you might be familiar with some of the electronic means of doing this. Text messaging, photo messaging, you can send each other images and words. But here's the thing, when you have direct psychic communication, you also get feelings. And you cannot interpret them, you just experience them. And that is what I'm most scared of right now. But I'm also most excited about it because of an opportunity. So, let's hope it works. Hello? Ring, ring. Ring, ring.
Bad.
Oh no, I can feel how bad you are. What's going on?
Well, I don't know. I just feel like, well, I don't think life's worth living.
What? Oh no. That's so sad. Wait, what? No. No, it is worth living. Are you okay? Where'd you go? I can't hear you. Where are you? I can't see
no.
you.
It's fine. I just needed to get a cigarette.
Oh. Okay. Well, what's... what's going on with the smoking?
Well, do you have a light?
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, no, I don't. But, you know, I do. I have this block of wood. Maybe I can just try to hand it. I can hand it to you and it'll transform into a lighter. Should we give
okay,
it a shot?
Let's give it a try. Hey, look, it worked.
Oh, yay.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
See, you see, smoking is a homeopathic remedy for feeling like you want to die.
I always learn something new from you. Is there anything else you need?
Well, do you have a beer?
No. But I have this block of wood.
I want a beer.
Maybe we can do it again. I'll try to hand it to you and it'll transform into a beer. Here it goes.
Okay. Oh no, it's just a cup of tea.
Oh. Well, it's common when working with new spiritual technologies for there to be glitches. So
that's okay, it's probably the best.
Yeah. You know, I've been thinking since you told me that you wanted to die, that I want to live, so. And something that always makes me feel more alive is when I hear you sing. It's always gives me the feeling of life. Would you think about maybe singing a song and maybe that feeling I get? And I'm not alone. There's a whole crowd of people who will feel it at the same time. Yeah. I mean, maybe if you concentrate, you'll be able to see them too. Try to see them.
Oh, I see them.
Yeah, it's amazing. Let's try to sing. Oh no, would you sing and help us all feel more alive, and then all that energy of our feeling more alive might be transferred to you.
Pretty good idea.
Wow, that was easier than I expected.
But this is a sad song, all you assholes.
Help.
Well, that's nice.
I just feel like, well, it just makes me so angry that human beings are the only animals of all the animals on the whole planet that take more than they need. You don't see a hummingbird taking all the nectar and then telling all the other hummingbirds to fuck off.
Yeah.
I mean, I just wish that I could be like all the other animals on the planet and just have everything I needed.
Well, maybe, you know, I enjoyed giving you that light and the tea. Maybe I can give you something that you need now. Is there anything that you, is there anything that you need?
Well, maybe a sandwich?
I don't have a sandwich, but I have this block of wood. Maybe I can try to hand it to you and it'll transform into a sandwich. Here it goes.
Okay. You see, there was a lot of technological advancement based on the mind projector adapter. Some people got together and they couldn't figure out how to use it just using their minds and a projector. And so they created a small object about this big that you could sort of magnetically attach to your brain. They put a metal plate inside of it, and then you put a metal object on it, and then you could project your thoughts to the projector. And over time, over the course of a few hundred years, this object became smaller and smaller. And it became so small that they started implanting it directly into people's heads. And then these scientists wanted to continue to advance the technology, and they started to make it so small that it was imperceptible to the human eye. And it got to the point when it was just made out of a few simple elements. And they just looked at it one day and realized that the next step was obvious. It could just be a human cell. And this was shocking to them. They were like, oh my God, we're born
do this.
And we've been building and changing and creating all these things for so long, but we're actually just able to do it on our own. I could have told them that from the beginning. But the most frightening thing that happened was that the world turned into two factions. Those who believed that we were capable of this on our own, and those that still believed that we needed some sort of object outside of ourselves to facilitate these abilities. Now you'd think that once we realized we were capable of this on our own, it would bring peace on Earth. But in fact, the conflict raged on between people who believed that they could do it, and they did, and those that were kept continuing to advance the technology at an alarming rate. They no longer just wanted to use it on humans, they started hybridizing animals and machines and turning them into weapons to spy on the people who could do it without anything. And then the people who could do it without anything were using their power to project themselves into the minds and spaces of all the people using the technology that turned into a global war. And I was like, this wasn't supposed to be like that. And I realized I'm not a politician. But I've learned a few things in my experiments. And so, I was walking on one day and I found something discarded in a dumpster. And this thing was, in fact, one of the discarded animals that was hybridized into, it was a bird and a camera combined into one. It was shocking. But when I picked it up, I realized it was alive. It had consciousness and I could communicate with it. And we became the best of friends. So I want to introduce you to my friend, Igor. Now, she's asleep. She sleeps very well. So I'm just going to introduce you to her. And then we're going to watch over there and do our thing. And our thing is being entertainers who represent the two sides and try to be like a USO for both sides, entertaining and hopefully, you know, keeping it easy for all the new psychic warriors out there. So here she is.
This is my
Hello? That sounds like me. And now I'm going to put my little friend Perch here. She's a bird. She can perch. And I'm going to take the mic. Oh, wait, no, I'm not.